All right, so it is August 22nd. Frank and I are scouting for his elk hunt, and I just heard the first bugle of the year. So I'm going to go ahead and throw a bugle out there.
Oh, look at that sexy dude. Oh, yeah.
Nathan.
Hey, sweet. Yeah, thanks. Glad you were able to make it out.
Yeah. Ooh. Looks good. Go ahead, dude.
Two water holes we've checked so far are very full. There's no way this thing's drying up in a month. In 3 weeks now. Practice makes perfect, dude.
Follow my YouTube channel.
You're calling some geese, dude.
Good bull. Good bull. Can't tell exactly, but he's got antlers. Come here, you want to look? You can just see the antlers. You can just make out that he's got a frame.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Ooh. Ooh.
That's a better view.
Frank.
For being that far.
Frankie.
I'm well on my way to my dreams coming true, and I'm getting to do it with you.
All right, so this is Frankie's 110 yard shot. The reason why you don't see an elk is because singing along way over there. Banjo. Did I take it all back? Take it all back? Take it all back? I take it all back just to have you. Yeah. Did I take it all back? Take it all back? Take it all back? I take it all back just to have you. And one day we might have a big house with nice cars and fancy clothes and a wife with a big old diamond ring. Cause the people, they dancing along to the mando in some sort of hip-hop beat. Dude, you ready to kill a big bull this weekend, dude? And guys, Ted's gonna be up tomorrow morning. Danny's coming up tomorrow night. Dad'll be up tonight. Yeah. Alright, so I'm watching this bull. He's pretty rut. He's rutting decently hard. He, I think, is... He should be right. Right at the tip of my finger. But yeah. So good. Good night. I think if, you know, Sunday or something like that, I bet you Frank could take him. He's a 6x6. He's a better 6-on-1. The nice thing is he's rutting. He bugled back to me and he was wallowing and raking this freaking tree for like 2 minutes now. So that's good to know. He is rutting. The rut at least is on over here. Or at least he thinks the rut's on. So... Frankie did say he spotted a bull with 8 cows, so I'm curious if we got any footage of him. That'd be sweet. But, alright. Talk to you guys later. Alright, here we are.
Oh, yeah. Ready or not, here we come.
Frankie, opening morning, dude. And we're out here, man.
Waiting for this for a long time.
Alright. Nice and crisp, cool morning.
Yeah.
Let's get all to right. it.
So not too bad actually.
Look at that stud of a hunter.
Oh yeah. So 4.5 miles.
That's it?
Well, because we added a lot of miles or a lot of distance when we were like chasing the bull and walking around. So
that's true.
Because we drove the
4.5 miles this morning chasing the bulls.
I mean 6 miles.
Yeah, 6 miles. So 4.5 miles chasing the bulls. Frank, what's the plan?
Just go back and eat a sandwich and drink some water. And then I think we're gonna stay here and I think we'll take the rhino in further. I'll walk.
We're gonna take how far do we walk?
4.5 miles.
We're gonna take the ranger 4.5 miles further.
Yeah. And then probably take a nap and just kind of stay out all day.
So right now Frankie's trying to show me his song. Chris Stapleton says bottle, but he says it sounds like butthole. it's the little things in life, man. What time is it now, Frank?
It's not 6 yet. It's almost 2:40.
We're waiting for about 6:30.
Stick.
7:39. Finally got back to the freaking truck. These are long days, man. These are really long days. Trying to find that balance of being able to be out here and be efficient, but also not wear yourself out. I think that is a very, very key component of this hunt, not wearing yourself out. You want to hunt hard. Oh yeah.
All right guys, update. So Saturday morning, got to our spot and we got beat to our spot by another hunter. So we had moving a little bit south. Saw a big bull. He ended up heading east, so we jumped in the rhino and ran around. He jumped in front of us, at like 20 yards. So I jumped out and tried to knock an arrow, but I couldn't draw. As soon as I tried to draw, he spooked. Never saw him again. And then we spotted a bull north of us, about a mile and a half. A nice little 6-point. So we went after him. Kept bugling, and we could tell where he was, but we couldn't see him. So that was kind of a little bit frustrating. We're headed back to camp now to try to reevaluate the situation. There are a ton of people.
Reevaluate situation, expectation,
yeah.
Commitment.
But there are tons of people at the place where we're hunting. There's a ton of dudes. Guys,
big gulps, huh?
Anything I missed in my update? Whatever to give you some sick content.
Just super sick content. No. No, we don't need to talk about that, I guess. No. Just Frank and I, man. Woo.
You were cold as the blood through your bones, and the light which led us from our chosen home. Well, I was lost. Now I sleep. Sleep the hours that I can't weep. And all I knew was steeped in blackened hopes. Well, I was lost.
Looking right at us.
Both of us if you can.
Alright, well it's on now, but I can't. Oh, it's shining right on my face, that's why it's dark. Let's change that. Nice. Alright, so it is September, what's the date today? 22nd?
22nd.
And Frank just got a bull down. I don't know, maybe you need to do the narrative.
Frank
got a bull down about an hour ago, hour and a half ago, about 6:50. Took a shot. And so he's up there by himself. He did a one dayer up there. And so Gus and I are heading up, helping pack it out. Dang, I can't believe it.
Yeah, no kidding.
So we haven't seen any pictures of this thing. And it better be massive. Just kidding. Right. Oh my gosh, all right, so we just pulled up to Frank. It is, guess what time is it?
It is.
Dude, it is dark.
10:04.
10:04. 10:04 is pulled into Little Diamond. Frank's been waiting.
Oh,
holy smokes. Frank.
Dude.
Nice bringing in, dude. It's awesome, Grizz.
Thanks, man. Thanks for
getting it done. Holy crap. Camp on Tuesday for a morning. Decided to stay the rest of the day.
It was like the last minute of light.
We kind of figured when you said, I don't know if I hit him.
Yeah. Well, it was also like, it sounded like a, and I was like,
oh yeah, that's a good shot.
I'm like, I either hit the mud.
Oh my gosh.
Or
you hit all vitals.
So it was a lung shot. Oh.
When he did, I was out back.
I got the picture of the beer afterwards. I'm like, oh, that looks really good.
So what was it feeling like being up here by yourself, having taken that shot?
Really quiet and frustrated. popped out. And yeah, literally, like, there's maybe 5 minutes, maybe 2 minutes left of light.
He did come with a cow?
He did. And luckily the cow didn't spook.
Holy cow.
He knew I was there. Like he definitely was like looking at me. Looking my way, but.
Oh my god.
No. Now I'm getting cold. Here's the euro.
Oh, dude.
The only thing I was sticking up was this in the mud. And I'm like, please tell me that's just not the red fletching.
No kidding.
Holy smokes, dude.
There it is.
There it is.
I gotta get a picture of that.
Save this arrow. Okay. Yeah, literally like
hold still over it.
He's like in perfect shape too, dude. That thing just went through.
Dude, like I can actually just go shoot it again.
Yeah.
Dude.
Yeah. So it was like this in the mud. So I'm like, please tell me there's something else that's red on that thing.
No way, dude.
I was in there.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly where I shot from.
Al came in over here and the bull came in behind her.
Oh, dang. Yeah, so this is the blind I was in, Frank, right here.
So I almost said this, like, dude, there's no, like, it's so, sorry. Anything here, I'm shooting my 20-yard pin, 50-yard pin, 40-yard pin, I'm like, just straight simple.
Yeah.
I'm like, yes. Yeah, so he's drinking up here. And so my little crank, so he was sitting here drinking, and he was going here, and my arrow literally was like laying right here.
Holy no crap. Kidding.
There's hardly any water left in here.
Dude, that's what he was drinking?
Holy seriously. Shit.
Man, I don't know if he's good to eat anymore.
That's when I saw this, I was like, man, I wonder if actually they'll even come in. But, no shit.
You can smell the piss.
Yeah.
Wow.
Well.
Oh yeah, dude. That is awesome.
This is where I picked his blood drill up again.
Holy crap.
Wow.
There he is.
Holy smokes, dude. That is awesome.
Definitely not like...
Oh my gosh, dude.
Huge. At least we can stiff.
Frank, congrats, no, dude. No.
Congratulations, Frank, dude. That is a big deal.
Yeah, dude. Thanks for I mean, did you mind grabbing like glove chips?
Frank, do you want to say anything else, man, or get behind him one more time and say something real quick, or I know we need to get going, but
yeah. Well, the sun was hard, man. And thanks to, I mean, Gus, you.
Totally.
You busted your balls, dude. Helping me out.
Oh man.
You guys together were pressing to watch.
Worst case, I mean, this is my first archery kill. So let alone, archery bull. I never killed him with the bow, so it just. And yeah, I was praying to St. Hubert. I'm like, dude, you gotta help me. I'm like, just give me a chance. Give me a chance to redeem Sunday. That's all I wanted.
South where the highland fades, there's a poor man working in a rice-filled maze, and a barefoot boy on a jetty plank as he walks into the goal. In a lighthouse shining out to the sea, to the shrimpers staring in disbelief, and the mermaid saying he's gotta believe that a light will take him home. And by the Mississippi River there's a southbound train, and it's headed for the goal. Gonna buy my ticket and hold it tight till I know I'm getting close. See me running down the alleyway, looking for the jetty, searching for my soul. You know, change their mind. I'm tired of the hustle, get out on the bustle every time I see the light. Tell me, baby, can you feel my soul? I'm rolling with the rhythm on cruise control. I got three chords and I speak the truth to Willie Nelson, that's a country song. By the Mississippi River there's a southbound train, and it's headed for the goal. Gonna buy my ticket and hold it tight till I know I'm getting close. Running down the alleyway, looking for the jetty, searching for my soul. You know, oh, I'm headed for the coast.
Little cat there too, but
yeah.
I did.
Can I have a sip?
Yeah. So just telling the guys, just like it was definitely a tough hunt. But appreciate everyone's help and effort, and Gus and Ted and T, Matthew, coming up and helping me pack it out. It would have taken me all night.
Yeah, I'd have taken anybody all
to do that. While. So, but thanks to Gus, all of his effort. Mm-mm. Gus did a ton. All the scouting weekends and all that stuff.
I just scared a bunch of bulls away. That bull's like, damn, that chick sounds like he's got hair on her chest.
Too much angle to dangle,
you know? Polaroids of you guys hanging up on trees.
You can use the cap, I guess. So, to you guys.
All right, dude.
Oh, that does warm the heart.
Is that whiskey?
Mm-hmm.
It's not.
Come on, Dad, I had beer.
It's not Pepsi.
Good grief.
And remember his beer.
You're gonna get
more on your you'll beer than you will.
Yeah, you'll smell like it tomorrow, but not because you drank too much.
Whoa.
Well, cheers, Frank. You did a hell of a job, dude.
Thanks,
Frank. Congratulations. Thanks for bringing us back together one more time, man. That was awesome. Yeah. Holy smokes!
I was gonna say, like, you know, before. And I saw the sun was going down, and I just saw the waning just moments go by. I'm like, at least I can't say I didn't try.
Yeah.
And, you know, had good opportunities, and, you know, they call it hunting, not killing.
Yeah.
But was it quiet all the way up to the end?
Yeah.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Never give up.
I was sitting outside at like 6:20. I think it was 6:20 when I went outside. And I had checked the beer and I was waiting for Frank. I was like, man, I was like, at any moment I could get a text from Frankie that he got a bull. So I was laughing, and then all of a sudden I get a ding on my phone and a little tiny icon drops down and like shows you like the first like few words of the text. I was like, just shot a bull.
Oh, yeah. Dude, that's awesome.
And then like 6:30 came, 6:40 came, and a bark. I'm like, okay, like, and I'm like, at this point, I've got a couple minutes left. And I'm like, this is it. Like, these need to come in at dark, right as I'm packing up. And sure enough, dude, a cow jumps out to my right, and then that bull, that 5-point bull pops out to my, like, kind of right behind her, but goes straight for the water. And he kind of looks over at me, and goes to the water and looks at me, and kind of goes back to the water. And so once he went behind the tree, the cow is still standing to my right. And at that point, I'm like, forget what the cow does. Like, that's what screwed me on Sunday.
Dude, yeah, you learned and you freaking adjusted, so, man. Good job.
Yeah, I'm just going to, so I drew back, and he just put his head down to drink, and I just like, okay, all right, here goes, nothing, boom, shot, and
dude,
it felt good.